Sahu, welcome to SNPs Biology. In the previous class, we have discussed about the difference between eukaryotic and prokaryotic cell. In this class, as you have already read the topic, we are going to discuss about the components of a typical plant cell and an animal cell. So let's start with the plant cell. A typical plant cell. So, a typical plant cell mainly has two parts. That is the cell wall and the protoplast. The cell wall is the non-living part of the plant cell, whereas the protoplast consists of both living as well as non-living part. In the protoplast, there are three components. The first one is the cell membrane, what we call as also the plasma membrane. The vacuole, which is centrally placed and large in structure. The vacuole represents the non-living part of the protoplast. And the third one is the protoplasm. Clear? The protoplasm is the living part of the cell which consists of two parts. That is the nucleus and the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, we find three types of structures, some organelles, some inclusions, and the cytosol. Whereas in nucleus, we find three components, that are the nuclear membrane, the nucleoplasm, and the chromatin network. In the nucleus also present the nucleolus, which has the nucleolar membrane. As we are considering a typical plant cell, a typical eukaryotic plant cell, we will study about the true nucleus. Clear? Where the nucleolus consists of the nucleolar membrane and the nucleus has the nuclear membrane. Now, let's discuss what are the organelles, what are the inclusions, and what is the cytosols and their components. As I have already told that the cytoplasm has three components, the organelles, inclusions, and the cytosol. Let's first start with the cytosol. The cytosol is also called as the hyaloplasm or the cytosolic matrix or the cytoplasmic matrix. Clear? So, in the cytosolic matrix, there are three components we can found, that is the water, some micromolecules, and some macromolecules. The micromolecules are the low weight substances present in the cytosol, whereas the macromolecules are the larger weight substances present in the cytosol. These substances have smaller size, whereas these substances have, or the these molecules have larger size. Now comes to inclusions. Inclusions are also called as the ergastic substances, or the metaplastic bodies, So in the inclusions, we find mostly three kind of substances. Some molecules are reserved reserved components. Let me erase this. Some molecules are reserved components of the cell. Some are the secretory products, whereas some are the excretory products. So, reserve components includes carbohydrates, proteins, fats and oils, nucleic acids, amino acids, etc. Whereas the secretory products include the pigments and nectar enzymes. The excretory products include gums, tannins, alkaloids, organic minerals, etc. Clear? Now let's come to the organelles. The organelles, we can also call them as the organoids. There are various organelles that we found inside a cell. Considering the plant cell, a typical plant cell consists of plastids, which is absent in case of animal cell. Plastid has a special pigment called as the chlorophyll pigment, which is found inside the chloroplast, which helps the plant to photosynthesize. But animal cell cannot photosynthesize itself. Clear? It is completely dependent upon other organism to take up its food. So plastid is the characteristic feature of plant cell. Remember that. Then the Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, then glyoxysomes, peroxisomes, it's not in the inclusion, peroxisomes, next the spherosomes, the lomasomes, cilia and flagella, the ribosomes, then the lysosome and the cytoskeleton. So these are the structures that we found inside a living plant cell. Clear? We will discuss about these structures in the coming of classes. Now let's discuss about the structures associated with a typical animal cell. A typical animal cell. I have already told you that the cell of an animal lack the cell wall. Cell wall is only present in case of plants. So there is no cell wall in the animal cell. And I have already told that the protoplast includes which structures? The vacuole, the cell membrane and the protoplasm. But there is no large central vacuole in case of animal cell. But there is the presence of cell membrane and the protoplasm. So we cannot call that the animal cell contains the protoplasm. Clear? So considering the components of an animal cell, It has the cell membrane and the protoplasm. In the protoplasm, there is present the nucleus and the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, there are organelles, there are inclusions, and there is the cytosol or the haloplasm. So, organelles like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi bodies, ribosome, peroxisome, centrosomes, lysosomes, your mitochondria, then cilia and flagella, cytoskeleton are all present inside the plant, so inside the animal cell. Clear? And the inclusions include various reserves, food materials, enzymes, etc. So, this much for today's class. In the next class, we will discuss about how to draw the structure of a typical plant cell and a typical animal cell, including all the cell components. If you like this video, show your love by giving it a thumbs up, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon so that you can get all the updates. Thank you.